Very well, here we are again. And last video, the sound was a little bit too close. I need my piece of foam. Or I need the piece of foam. I need the piece of foam. The foam. The rounded foam that fits over the end of the microphone. It's in the house. We are cooking or steaming a batch of rice. Here's our steamer right here. There we have it. And inside, let's see if we can see that. It has rice, split pea, brain food right here. These are little brain foods. It has some corn in it. And I put some pinto bean flakes. It's red because it has a little bit of jarred spaghetti sauce. And I put some Himalayan sea salt in it, some pepper, and some some garlic salt and onion salt. And cell salts in it. It has the Aries cell salt in it, the Cali phosphate. It has the Capricorn cell salt, which is the regular Himalayan sea salt. It has the iron in it. And the I have the Aquarius Okay, let's think this through. Now, everyone, when they're born, we are missing a quadrant of cell salts. This body was born in Capricorn, which is the very south of the zodiac. Aries is at the equator. It's above the equator, directly across from Virgo. Aquarius, Pisces, and Aries would be the cell salts. Let's see here. See, this body was born on January 9th in Capricorn. Therefore, it was conceived 9 months before that, which would be Aries. Or Taurus. Let's see here. Is to reverse engineering. Capricorn would be 9. Sagittarius would be 8. Scorpio would be 7. There we go. Scorpio would be 7. Before Scorpio, we have Libra. Libra would be 6. My mother is a Libra. Libra is also a cardinal sign. Libra 6, Virgo would be 5, Leo would be 4, Cancer would be 3, Gemini would be 2, Taurus would be 1, that's 9. I was conceived in Taurus, and I looked up the moon in Taurus. That's where it was a three-quarter moon on a Tuesday. I was conceived. I figured. Well, Tuesday, I was born on a Tuesday, that's right. I figured I was conceived on a Thursday. I looked up the history calendars of the moon cycles. So we were conceived in Taurus, born in Capricorn. Therefore, Aquarius, Pisces, and Aries would be the three cell salts, or the quadrant, that this body would be sufficient in. I have some Aries salt, which is the caliphosphate, and I have Capricorn salt. For some reason, Mother was saying that it's also good to take our sign salt. For Capricorn, it is the iron, which would be the Himalayan sea salt. Therefore, this body needs the Aquarius salt and the Pisces salt. I think I have the Pisces salt inside. The jar is empty though. We put in Himalayan sea salt and the caliphosphate salt. The Salts of Salvation. It's a good book by George Carey. It tells us all about the importance of the zodiac and how the planets actually reflect the energy of salts for these bodies. I'm learning that the cell salts are the most important things, minerals, to put into the body. These cell salts bring balance. These cell salts bring the deficiency, or bring the power of thought to the optimum level to be able to influence all the effects of the planets in the solar system, in the universe. Right now we're facing southwest, just right of 45 degrees center of southwest. This right here is east to west straight line. This right here is north to south, straight line. And the sun is right here. 45 degrees would be right here. So we're actually inside this center 45 degrees, and the eastern direction. So we're centered in between south, southeast, or southwest. Sun rises in the east, sets in the west. So we're in between the south, west, and west. Facing directly into the sun. This is our first elongated sun exposure for the year 2015, here in this lovely month of March. I hear the birds tweeting. I hear the water in the steamer bubbling. We moved to a new location in the yard to optimize the sun, because to the southwest there is a large 100-foot tall evergreen tree. There's a siren and the horn. Bird chirps. The time is 4:29, so we are now again in the electrical hours, 2 hours of electrical energy. You know, we notice how the last 2 hours we were in the magnetic energy, which is the female energy. And we rested. Between 2 and 4 are hours of rest. Between 4 and 6 are hours of activity. And I'm seeing that it's naturally happening. At 6 o'clock, we will enter into 2 more hours of female energy, which is the magnetic energy. It's the reflective energy. It's the receiving energy. It is the energy that births forms. So it seems at 6 o'clock in the morning, we receive electrical sun energy from 6 to 8. Then we rest from 10 to 12. 6 to 8 would be the power of thought. 10 to 12 would be the birth of forms. 12 to 2 would be the power of thought again. Through by way of the previous 2 hours, which would be 10 to 12, the female form that was birthed as a result of the 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. electrical energy, We looked in the mirror, and the face was pinkish in color from the sun rays. The banks will be closing at 5 o'clock within a half an hour. Today is the last day according to the letter. Or, see, is today Wednesday? Nope, it's Thursday. Yep, today's the last day. The banks said that they would close the public account on the 26th, which is today, Thursday. Let's double check that. Yep, 26th. And tomorrow was supposed to be sunny forecast. Saturday, clouds, rainy. Whoop, there's some little raindrops on Friday. Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Mostly sunny, so it says. So now I'm going to use the power of my thoughts to make all those days pure sunshine. And this is the thing that the cell salts, the power that it gives us, is the power to change the weather. If we happen to look at any forecasts. My habit lately has been to just use my thoughts to bring the weather that's most pleasing. I noticed too that we have a much more pleasing sound with a softer voice and a smoother opening of the lips. Smoother opening and closing of the lips, which would be a slower. And the cock just crowed in Mother Nature's confirmation of that. Those words spoken. We are making a conscious effort to enter into ease, pleasantness, joy, relaxation. Wow, that was a race car engine that just revved at the highest RPM it could for about 1.5 seconds. That was a huge confirmation of power. When we relax like this, we are activating the germ in the kundalini in the middle of the spine that rises from the chakra. There was another high-powered rev. Confirmation of Mother Nature of the superior words that were just spoken. Another rev with the private thought that I had. Another rev. Another rev. Shorter revs though. Less RPMs. Mother Nature is revving in confirmation, letting us know that energy and power is entering. When we relax like this, I feel a sensation in the middle of the spine. See, make adjustments there. We are envisioning. There was another rev. We are envisioning the energy in the middle of the spine. The body is wanting to talk, however, the mind is wanting to relax. Another rev. We're thinking of the birds. They're mostly quiet. There was a chirp. Here is an ant crawling on the arm. Thoughts of the bank account are entering in. There was a voice from a neighbor that said, "Yeah." We're also having thoughts of trust, relaxation, and feeling good. Feeling good is the superior power over all manifestations. When we wait in trust of the rest backed through the spirits in the universe to bring about our desires, to provide all that's necessary for our ascension. There's talking in the bike path. Children are talking. of them said something like, "You." These are all nature speaking. Nature speaks through people. All we have to do is center on the perspective of the larger picture. This body has had 2 hours of sleep in the last 48 hours. Maybe 3 hours of sleep. It stayed up a full 24 hours. And it slept this morning between the hours of 2 and 4. Or 1 and 4. Or 2 and 5. Somewhere around there. And then it wanted to wake. The eyes felt sore. The soreness went away after half an hour. When we woke up early this morning, we shared our talents freely on the internet, our words, typing words for people to soak in. This body has, alright, we want to remain in the moment now. Let's remain in the moment. Yes, the moment. This is the thing we desire, the moment. Ah, the sun feels warm, energizing. Starting to descend toward the horizon, so the strength of this brightness is diminished enough to open the eyes, be able to hold one eye open at a time and get some direct sunlight into the pineal gland. Beautiful. Open the left eye, look into the sun. And see the flaring rays of brilliance. If it's too much, then look away from the sun, or blink the eye. The pituitary gland and the pineal gland are known as Joseph and Mary. These are the representative Bible story characters. The two hemispheres of the brain are connected through what's called the Red Sea. The Red Sea is represented in the Old Testament. The thalamus would be the third eye. It's represented by the Ark of the Covenant. The caduceus, used to represent the icon symbol for hospitals, is representative of the spine, and the wings at the top represent the left and the right brain. The two serpents entwined, traveling up the stem of the caduceus, or the staff of the caduceus, are the two vagus, or two nerves, that run from the root chakra back up to the brain, up to the Holy of Holies. Here's a siren, a motorcycle. We're staying focused of inner thought and outer awareness, a balance between the both. There's a low-flying plane I hear in the distance, a bird chirp. These are all in synchronization with the thoughts. We read the Capricorn natal astrology chart for this body, and there's another rev, a motorcycle shifting. Birds chirping. We're feeling the heat, the awareness of the heat of the sun, the energy of the sun. Mild wind blowing. Looking at the back of our eyelids now, focusing in. Looking at shapes now. Mirages. The wind blowing stronger in confirmation. The universe reminded us to look at the back of the eyelids again. This is where we start to see pictures and visions. Staying aware of our outer awareness while we focus on the back of the eyelids. So now we have three synchronicities. The outer awareness, the pictures on the back of the eyelids, in synchronization with thought. That would be the Trinity, the trust. Grantor, beneficiary, trustee. And each one shares equally. Rotating positions. A deep rumble of a truck engine. Thinking of the steaming. Opened our eyes, we see the steam rising out. Water drops inside the plastic clear cover. We're thinking about rising to check the water level, because we don't hear no bubbling. So now we're allowing the grass to dry today, and then we're going to mow the grass, and we'll put that on tape. We'll record that. Somewhat hot. There's some water left in there. We can actually take the spoon and put more water. Put more water back in. monitoring the pain in the lower back as we're at an awkward angle, making sure that we maintain health and gentleness back there. Here we are. We'll take a look at the goodies here. Here they are. We'll stir them up. And we see that they're going to need more. We'll get a little bit of it. We'll save some of it, put it down there. Tiny will have some to eat. They still need to cook more, or steam more. There we are. And here's Tiny, she loves this. It's too hot. Have us a little bit of half cooked. There's more nutrients in this when it's half cooked. We need to get the body used to it more, though. That's why we fully steam it. Chew it gently. Nice. Being gentle on clenching our teeth together. Just crying softly. Here. Careful. You can see her body really wants the nutrients. Share saliva like the Indians do in India. They eat with the animals and share saliva with the animals. This is why they are the happy, healthiest immune systems on the planet. So we've been slowly but surely doing this for the last 2 years. Chew it nice and long and get the digestive enzyme and the saliva. This cat has yet to eat mice, so I practice with her often. Is my starting point. I'm careful with the cat, female cat Boobs, who eats mice all the time, so I introduce her saliva at a lighter rate. Hold on, we have some more steamers. Yeah, we have some more steamers. See, I do happen to have a can. I'm going to go get a can. Here, let's go over here. I'm going to get a can so I can pour that water in there. Because it's going to need more water than that to finish steaming. This was a double batch that I did this time. Thank you. So I use this cranberry sauce can to pour the water in. Just put it right there. Tiny's looking around for more goodies. Her body is very attracted to that ricey, fresh brown rice. Fresh lentils are in there also. Bento bean flakes from the food bank. The lentils were from the food bank. There's corn in there and some brain beans. Garbanzo beans are in there. Those are high nutrition brain food right there, is the garbanzo beans. This will be the first time I've ate some in about 5 years. I bought the garbanzo beans 5 years ago when I was working a job, and I experimented for a week eating no meat, just cheese, lettuce, garbanzo beans, other things. However, for the first time in my life, I put some raw garbanzo beans in my pocket while I was offloading wood from the press, and I would put one garbanzo bean in the mouth and let the saliva dissolve it slowly, surely. I probably dissolved 10 garbanzo beans that week. That was the first time in my life that I felt my body's weakness from just eating cheese, lettuce. And working full time in the back of a press, lifting 4x8 sheets and smaller boards. Some heavier boards. Sometimes we'd have some 1.5 inch thick particle board or MDF. Most of it was 3/4 or 3/8. We made top of the line wood for desks and walls. And we made some lower grade rustic looking veneered wood with knot holes in it that we would putty. We did door skins. Douglas fir veneer for smaller cabinets. One time we made some pieces of wood for some organs. We had a rounded press. We made round pressed organ boards. It was well as bigger ones. Organs, as in musical organs, like pianos. Having thoughts of one of the supervisors, who was actually the owner of his own company that went out of business, and he was hired on used to do public television show for the city of Eugene, or we used to. We, as in all of us spirits put together, replacing the word I with we, brings unity. There's the neighbor's voice, female voice. Birds are chirping. Now we're much more in balance now with the outer awareness and the inner thoughts. Balancing out the inner thoughts of ego. There's the truck in the outer world, revving the motor, softly driving. Another truck, the same truck, finishing its stop sign, revving through the intersection. We have a freeway cross, a quarter mile away, both directions. It's a Interstate 5 going north to south, and Highway 126 east to west. We can hear the freeway noise, my old freeway noise. When we lived in San Ramon, California, from 1980 to until I joined the military, till we joined the military in 1986, we lived right behind the 680 freeway, Interstate 680. Couple miles south was Interstate 580 running east to west. 680 ran north to south, and we had a cock crow. Maintaining a relaxed speaking pace, noticing the body, the root chakra. Rest. Let us rest. When we speak, it's we feel the pressure in the root chakra. We'll maintain the pressure, or we'll maintain relaxedness in the root chakra while we speak, needing less speaking. Let us rest. looks like down here. Being very gentle around the ant. We want the ant to live. To be healed and whole. Maintain his wholeness. The neighbors, car door. Focusing on the back of the eyelids once more. Lightly checking for an ant. Feeling the wind blow the heat of the steam on the left leg, lower leg, side of the shin. We love ourselves. We love you, body. We love you, heart. We love you, lungs. Be healed, be whole. Health and prosperity is yours. We love you, feet. We love you, toes. We love you, hands. We love you, eyes. The eyes are responding. The back of the eyelids are turning different colors, different shapes. We love you, eyes. There is a radiant flash of sun. Being general until energy for specifics rises. Birds tweeting. Focusing on the Kundalini, the two serpents of the spine, the caduceus, the two wings representing the brains, left and right brain. Relaxing our voice down, needing more of a lower relaxation. Yes. Feeling the vibration more. Yes, much very relaxing. There we are. That's what we needed. Regulation. Tonal voice regulation. Sounds like a squirrel. Squirrel on the fence. The steam feels good. We are bare feet. Bare feet are on the grass, grounding the body. Having its first lengthy ground.
body's having its first lengthy ground with a deeper tone, more relaxation. Notice the position of the arms resting and up straight in a relaxed position. Now they want to go up here like this. Tiny the cat. I'll move slowly so as not to startle Tiny. We want her to be relaxed as possible. There she is. It's 5:14. We've been recording for as the steam blows in the face. Looks like 57 minutes. There you go, Tiny. Use my foot to see if we can see it. Looks like 57 minutes. We'll go to 5:30, so it'll be an hour and some video. The banks should be closed at 5 or 5:30. Traffic, we hear traffic. People should be getting off work. Traffic's increasing. We haven't worked a job since 2008 of October. We were self-employed from 2008 till 2011. Or 2012, we did 4 years of forex trading. And we traded back to the banks $130,000 in Federal Reserve debt notes. Then in 2012, we sold items on Craigslist for probably a couple years. We went around collecting free stuff in the city on free Craigslist and then sold it. I sold tires, some 4x4 tires, a set of tires and rims. Big monster tires, 15-inch rims, and 33-inch tires. I loaded 6 of those tires in the Subaru. We sold a guitar for $450. It was a Tom DeLonge guitar that I bought on Craigslist for $100, turned around, made $350 profit. Sold all kinds of smaller items. This is in the past, though. Let's return back to the moment. Ah, yes, here we are, in the moment. This is where we want to be. Ah, the birds are chirping. The sun's shining. Tiny's here with us. Hi, Tiny. There we go. Much better. We're in the moment again. I feel much more alive. Yes. Even Mother Nature confirming it with another motor rev. Manufactured communication sign. A signature is a sign of nature. Much better, huh, Tiny? Yeah, careful with the claws. Careful with the claws. Birds are chirping. We are in the present moment. This is alive in the present moment. Inner and outer balance between thought. Now we just remember to look at the back of the eyelids again. To look for shapes and pictures and different colored lights from the sun. The trust, the triangle, the three points. Thoughts, the back of the eyes and the hearing. Then we have the square, would be feeling, touch. So we touch tiny. Ten more minutes left till 5:30. We'll look at the sun some more with the eyes. Get the pituitary gland. The energy of the sun rays. Vitamin D. Noticing the blue sky and the wonder of light causing the blue sky. I have a desire to see a YouTube video of the projection of the sun's light. The request for the universe. Maintaining our thought in the present moment. Keeping our mind from drifting into the past or into the future. Staying in the present moment. Relax. Yes. Change the tone of the voice. More relaxed. Yes, there we are. More relaxed. More relaxed. Crow tweeting. The caw of a crow. There we are. The birds pick up on the energy. Overhead plane jet. High jet. That's a big confirmation from Mother Nature. There it is. Nice, low, relaxed voice. Can you hear that plane? We can hear it. Had confirmations like that multiple times throughout the last year. Maintaining our focus in the present moment, though. Maintaining our focus in the present moment, though. There we go. Much more relaxed. Should have around 7 more minutes left. Without lifting our eyes to look, we'll gauge it internally. Relaxed voice. Maintaining our outer awareness. Maintaining our thoughts on the outer awareness. There was a new one. Maintaining our thoughts on the outer awareness. thinking of the body, thinking of the yard, the grass, the sun. That was a higher level notch. There it is. We've been here before. There's birds chirping. Confirmation. There it is. Now we're in the moment. Seeing the back of the eyes. Our thoughts are now on all of nature around us. It only took us an hour to get here. Now we'll enjoy this last 5-7 minutes focusing on the yes. The steam of the steamer. Tiny's looking for rice in the ground. That Tiny. Be a few more minutes, Tiny. We'll check it again. She's hungry, huh? Yeah, she's hungry. There she is. She likes the nice deep voice. Yes. You like that deep voice, huh? Yeah. Beautiful. Using my thoughts to retract her claw from the skin, and it's working. The power of thought, here it is. Using the power of our thought to heat the sun up more. We will now focus on the last bits of the sun before it goes lower to the horizon. Using our thoughts to regulate the claw on Tiny the cat. She retracted. Now we are in synchronization with her brain, with her thoughts. Now we are in synchronization with all brains around the universe right now. Conscious of all the stars and the planets now. All animals, everything. Here we are. This is life right here. This is it. Pure present moment. Focusing our thoughts, our inner thoughts, our eyes on the back of the eyelids, hearing, feeling, all senses synchronizing together with the present moment of nature, here now. Tiny is very relaxed now that we went deeper into that. We are now connecting with all the YouTubers on YouTube. Everyone in the city. Officials, people. Governments. Washington, D.C. We're all connected now. Yes. Vibrations in the lower spine. Cock crow, bird fly by, low plane. Berg's tweeting much more vigorously, synchronizing with the thoughts of the birds. Another low plane. All signs, the wind's starting to pick up. Yes. I feel a nice vibration on the lounge chair near the chakras. We're wondering where it's from. However, not to spend too much time thinking about it, just enjoy it while it's there. Yes, we finally made it back. We are now here in the now. All thoughts, all senses synchronized together now. It's taken us a good part of the day to get here. We've done it though. Beautiful. And there's the rooster crow again. Confirmation. Yes. This is what we discovered last summer. We are only thinking about everything that's around us. Nice wind blow to confirm that. All thoughts are focused, all in on the body, everything. All thoughts around, people around, all brains connected. Everything is one now. This is a state of observation, pure observation. This is where the yogis, Muji, we are the one witnessing everything now. It's the pure state of feeling good. Witnessing everything. Focused in, witnessing all of nature around us. Including all thoughts, all stars, all universes. One universe, all galaxies. Traveling through the planet now. Being here at the same time, visiting relatives, visioning their houses, their neighborhoods, visioning everything in the backyard here, the heat of the sun. Now we're more focused on the back of the eyelids. Look at the sun, there we go, open eyes to the sun. Loving this so much right now, we're going to do overtime. We were thinking about stopping at 5:30, but this is, we finally entered in. We're going to stay here now. Yes. Made it. Good, 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 good. Looking at the teardrop-looking things in the air. The eyes squinted somewhat. Reflections, they look like planets. Okay. Little planets. Yes, we're starting to see reflections of lights. The planet. Miniature planets of lights before our eyes. Now we're over here. Streaks. Oh, we can see, looks to be earthquake cracks surfaces of the ice now, you can see. Now that we see those cracks, we can put our energy on healing those cracks and make them smooth again. The right eye looks more smooth. Left eyes, we see the cracks need to be healed. We see the specks. The right eye. The right eye is the creative brain, the right side. The left eye is the logical brain. Lightning bolt looking cracks in the left eye. Are experiencing, left eye is experiencing a burning sensation. Close the eye, open the right eye. Think about the clamoline or healing or hold. We have the clamoline in. I'm still feeling vibration in the lower back. Vibration. It's like spa water. That's the root chakra releasing its tension, sending energy. Focused heavily on the chakra now, while we maintain total awareness of everything else. We walk 2 feet, one step on land, one step on water. There's the cock crow for confirmation. Stepping on land represents thought, stepping on water represents the body. Be general, be general. We're being general. Awareness of time. Licking herself. Bird chirping. Feeling a nice vibration. Low voice. Running through the mid chest. Thoughts of mowing the yard are wanting to enter in. Seems how there's still some sunshine left. We should probably end this and mow the yard now. Yeah, let's do that. The rice is done steaming, so that's perfect timing. Alright, Tiny, you ready to get up? Like an hour and 25 minutes around there.